Scuba Scoop is sponsored by
Jesus is the Lord. Yesterday, someone actually called me and told me, T, I watched your episode of Scoop last night and it was crazy. You was coming from a type of place we don't understand with the cat story. And I wish I could tell you where I'm coming from. I wish I could make you all understand where that uninhabited anger comes from. But we only got 10 minutes on this show. I'm not going to waste them on that. We may visit it. Anywho, this show is proudly sponsored by Fanta. My name is Tina Fierce-Wan. Welcome to Scoop and Scoop. Now, I'm holding the copy of Bukede, and they have a big-ass headline. Sebulime yeganye omwana wa babirie. Lwachi koti ebagatulude. Jesus is the Lord. I've read the in-depth story in here, and what can I say? Hey, what can I say? Should we say that politics is what ruined Judith Mavidia as a person? Because before she had a political career, all of us just used to be like, Bambi, Chikazi Chatu, she was in a very bad relationship. It was an abusive relationship. She finally walked away. Bambi, netu imbi, no, ulizobu imba, wevera nange, no gamba banaye, Chikazi Chichi, no. Well, not according to Sebulime. Hey! Sebulime has come up with all sorts of accusations. He has come up with so much to say. I was watching at first when it went on online, and I was like, wait, let me grab the popcorn. Then when Bukede and my sister, when Bukede did the story, I call one a person from there, and I'm like, Soko Kape. And they're like, yo, binebi wamf. They are longer than the River Nile. So apparently, he's saying, the baby that she has, ngalie ya America, olubuto we agenda narwe, siwe. Reason, one, they never used to bang. This guy even remembers the last time he slept with his wife on the 22nd of December in 2018. Yo, you have got to be under some crazy type of deprivation to remember the day you last got laid. But that's besides the point. He says she was disrespectful. She would shout at him in public. She never trusted him to a point that even when Judith's daughter would come home to visit, ngatamukiriza nakusula yo mbwa inzo mukwata or something. That was, ooh, gory details, people. Gory details. Nega mbabulire. Mbagaze batero kuteka muopu mwana nabwa sende. But the marriages never last. Why? We do not know. There has to be something scientific about it. Because I didn't think this was going to go down the drain like this. I didn't. When Judith got married, we're all like, you know, she finally found her knight in shining armor. Everything is going to be good. But if he's having allegations like this, or take a call, what is that cousin called Josephine in English? Infidelity. Because by the time you're married to your husband says, "Oyo mwana si wange, obudde bwe nali naye," I don't think what. But you say, "Omulage na kugamba tosala ga kawala, ngo gwakale zitonda guuliriza." Judith has not yet come out to say anything. And these are huge allegations on her. But I think her even knowing she's not coming back, I highly doubt Judith Babidia is ever coming back to Uganda. Mpozinga Trump amukobye. Mpozinga bamukubida akasimu ne bakubira home office. Bajita batiye yamwe. Ne bagamba banaye ku number eri street. Yo mkazi taina mpapula. Mpozecho. Now she's not coming back. And it begs the question, I feel like, regardless of the fact that Sebulime has come out and said so many things about their failed marriage, there could be something deeper than rap. And I have a feeling Judith actually knew, onomwana gwe yazala siwa msajja n'agamba omanyi kanjiri nyembewo wano nga sinnamuzaala nswalire ekyaddondo. Because this Aisha, woo, child. But I'm not going to fault her. Because I know she also has her side, but it doesn't even count for nothing now. Because, I mean, they were given divorce. They had issues even before she left the country, but I'm still like, bana bahola bariye yonga mwesungu obufumbo. Hey, obufumbo sibwangu. Olaba bulema omulokole ngodo. Olaba bwalema mukazi wa bujingo. Mumanye waliwe bintu bye mwewanika konga sibya mwe. And I keep telling people this. Marriage is not meant for everybody. There are sacrificial lambs in this world that the Lord just put at strategic points in life to remind us that you could either be this or you could either be that. There are people who are actually picked out, I think, by the Lord not to get married. Like, how much bad luck would you have, Judith? How much? How much bad luck would you have? But hey, it's the career. Hey! What am I even doing? I'm being so Ugandan. Ha! I don't know. Sebulime has complained. He wasn't getting some. They treated him like crap. He was not happy at all. That's the reason why he went back to his first chick. Then I also look at this guy and I'm like, dude, we're kaliza, kotula. Te wandi yogede. Mwandi sigade yeyeyo, mkot yeyo. Why'd you guys have to tell us your daddy linen? Why? For us, we had already moved past the fact that you all broke up. We were okay. We knew y'all is not together. Did you feel your happiness? Nena kuzino nawasaja, but people keep saying but the quality of women in this country has dwindled. But the quality of men in this country, ay, there's something that is playing against them. Because sabulima simusaja muto. Simuto. Muna mwizo kubele obufumbo bwa munana. Bwetuga tako bebaso ke lako mchalo. So, ana. Bebe bifude Yerusalemu. Obaba nae vipi wafe chichene mkazi weba hachimaliriza batyo. Hachimaliriza. Professor Bukenya and his estranged wife. Yeah, they got divorced. They got divorced. Obusungu bwenabadde jjo, bwenabadde nnyina ku katsi jjo. Ala manyi wala sijja nakuddamu kuyisaamu linnya lye mu kamwa kange. But you people need to understand why I'm angry. I have my reasons of being angry. So, after all the shenanigans I talked about yesterday, MC Katz actually had a very awakening moment. He was with Pastor Wilson Bugembe. He went to the pulpit and he gave his life to Christ. So as we're speaking right now, Pastor Wilson Bugembe happens to be his chaperone and handler. Let's hope that goes swimmingly according to plan. My thing though is when he was on the pulpit and he was trying to give like testimony of what he's going through in his life, he says he knew he was HIV positive for 13 years. When we watch the first clips that came out, he claimed he had known for 9 years. Now just get that information and put it on the side, right? I'm going to talk about an organization that most people don't like to talk about, Kubamutia. So the United Nations, UN, gave him, I think they want him to be an ambassador or something, and he was talking about it. And I want to ask UN, someone tag them, do you know how many people have been in the struggle to sensitize about HIV AIDS in this country? There's doctors, there's researchers, there's nurses, there's so many people. There's children who was born with HIV AIDS and they have dedicated their entire lives to fighting the HIV scourge. Now, I understand that Katz right now seems like he can get a message across, but what are you showing the other people that have actually been in this struggle? What are you showing that what? They should also get friends, follow them, likes, be celebrities, and maybe the plight of an HIV/AIDS patient will be had in this country. There's people who have dedicated their lives to trying to get for people HIV meds because they are embarrassed to go pick them. And they actually sign up their names as those people. There's so much that has happened with the HIV scourge in Africa that I feel you have disrespected
expected all of that fight by handing MC Katz an ambassadorial job to do what? Huh? To show up in schools and tell kids stay in school and keep your pants up? Well, guess what? We've been telling our kids that forever. We have. The nation has, in general. Africa has. I just need someone to explain to me why we are, you know what? Because the hypocrisy that they use is on a whole other high. It's on an entirely bigger high. I find it very hypocritical. So if MC Katz hadn't come out, you were not going to get you an ambassador to fight the scourge, an ambassador who would probably fit the bill and the package. I have so many questions. I do. Most people will say I feel like I have a personal vendetta, but let me tell you, there's people out there who is more deserving for particular things. I feel so. Kubabu kwatu muntu akugamba 1 minute, 13 years. The next minute, 9 years. I'm even trying to ask, if you knew 13 years ago, did you wear protection with all the other women you slept with after finding out? Because if you didn't, that's actually criminal. Because then that means you spread it knowingly. Then if it was 9 years ago still, after you found out, did you wear protection? You have a baby with fear. Did she agree? Did you step up to her and tell her, yo, babe, I've known for 9 years. Or I've known for 13 years, I'm sick. And did she finally go like, I love you that much, let's catch AIDS together. It may sound very insensitive. But think about it in that angle. Think about it. That's the type of person we are giving all this sympathy. Because I know each and every one of us has someone who has died of HIV or knows someone who has HIV. And this, for me, is a lot of theatrics. People are out there on the front line on a daily fighting. They are fighting for their lives. And Katz has just turned it into one big social media craze. I mean, just think about it. And if you're a girl out there, and you're just finding out, I know you're scared of the stigma. You're just finding out now that you slept with Katz and he knew he was sick. And he still didn't tell you. What you gonna do? Live in, with HIV in peace? Or are you going to sue the bugger? My celebrities, munyizanyo. Our celebrities afford to live reckless lives. But what pisses me off the most, after they have lived their reckless lives, they now burden us to feel pain with them, which is not fair. Zenja chogera nchidem. Radio ya tulumanyo. Mumanyi wachi radio ya tulumanyo. Vakuch, the fact that we loved his music and all of that. Radio ya tulumanyo kubatu wa mleba agendirida. Nenga tusobula muga ambako. Ngatama mulikulu segere. Nabu bamutiete basobula muga ambako. And like that, he passed on and an entire nation was in grief, shock, confusion, anger. All the emotions were flying around. All these different celebrities you see out here don't deserve your sympathy because they are regular folks like you. Watch guamo, watch good demo. Because it seems the sympathy we give to them has forced them into thinking they are demigods. They are immortal. Because guawabato yoke deche zibu chokatinga guandavakat. Ani agendo kudukiri. I was going to like and follow and feel sad and create a hashtag for you. We should start reminding them they are not demigods. You mess up, that's what you get. Now handle up. I'm just disappointed by this whole thing because I know this fraternity. I know entertainment. I know the things that happen in this industry. I know how all our male artists just slip with the next, with the next, with the next. I know how our female artists will slip with the next, with the next, with the next. And what's sad? Because that's the world they know, right? They only know the world of entertainment, which means they keep switching up on bodies. So and so sleeps with this one, who sleeps in town with the other one, who sleeps in town with the other one, who sleeps in town with the other one. Kariyawo, but mubabulireko. If you're living a reckless life now, please, if you are an artist, if you're a movie star, whatever you are, if you know you are celebrated in this country, I need for you to understand, if you mess up, you cannot come and hit us with your pain, because we have our pain. So if you're out there living a reckless life, also understand that once it hits rock bottom, do not come to social. Don't come to social. Deal with your ish the way we deal with our ish. Hands on, in person. Mpaka, if you tap out, we'll be like, well, he fought the good fight. Because it's not fair. Not to you, not to me. It's not fair at all. Stop living your lives with reckless abandon and then coming out here and making it our fault. And I say this for all of us. All of us. It doesn't matter where you are. It doesn't matter if you're a radio person, a TV person, musical person, art, anything. This is a plea. It's easy for us to get ourselves in sticky situations because there's so much at our abandon. So much. We can get into so much. But as a person, where to know today? Don't let the life of fame and celebrity cloud your judgment, people. Don't. Don't. Or else you're going to end up like Kat, where he feels even the sympathy online is not going to help. Where he feels he still has to tell us everything because we are not helping good enough. Well, guess what, Kat? Even if you tell your story 1,000 times, we can't change back the hands of time. We can't. We can only move forward with positivity. Now, I'd expect you to come out and your message wouldn't have been the way you've been giving us the message. Your message would have been, yo, AIDS is real. AIDS is real. That's the message you were supposed to come out with. Not this crybaby nonsense. Anyway, Debio Katulinde, Pastor Wilson Bugemba Mtute. I hope it changes him. I hope he gives him what he's looking for, because at the moment, Josephine, do you know what Katz is looking for? What does he want? I'm trying to understand what Katz wants. So let's hope Pastor Wilson Bugemba ajachimanya bachikwasaganye, because I can't. I can't. I've tried. I can't. Damn. Anyway. At Tina Fierce, one is my Twitter handle. That's my Twitter handle. But sweeter. At Tina Fierce, one is my Twitter handle. And on Facebook, we are Scoop and Scoop. And on Instagram, it's at Tina Fierce, one with an H. On Snapchat, it's Tina Fierce, one. I'll catch you on the flip side, which is tomorrow. Yeah, it's going to be Woman Crush Wednesdays. Yay, can't wait. I'm out. Peace.
Scoop on Scoop was sponsored by